We did it, guys. We reached 10,000 subscribers on the channel. And to celebrate, I'm giving away my best lower third template for Premiere Pro. In this video, I'm gonna be showing you how to use it. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
Before we dive in, I just want to say really thank you for supporting the channel. It's been quite a journey so far. And in this video, I'm going to be showing you how to use this free template. So feel free to grab it in the link below. It's for free. So feel free to grab it, download it. I'm going to show you how it works inside Premiere Pro. All right, let's get started. So I'm inside Premiere Pro and I have a project open. To use the lower third template and to install it, just switch your workspace from editing to captions and graphics, and then navigate to this button at the bottom right-hand corner. This is to install a motion graphics template. So if you click on this button, you can navigate to the downloaded file. In this case, it should be named Reactive Lower Third Template. Now, what's really nice about this template is that it reacts to the text that you add in. So whether you have a very long name or short name, the rectangles and the different shapes will react to the length of the characters. So let's import this. I'm going to click open. And once you import it, you should see it right here. You just click and drag it to your timeline to install it. And if we play this back, this is what we have. So we have a nice lower third that pops up and we can customize all the different options here. So if we click on this and we go into master controls, this is where you can change the position, size, and rotation of the entire lower third. So you can click and drag these sliders to reorientate where the lower third is. So really, if you want this at the top of the screen, you can do that. If you want to make it smaller or bigger, you can. But for now, I'm going to undo that. And now what's really nice, if we go into the name controls, you'll see the power of this lower third template. Let's say if we change the name, for example, to John, you can see that it resizes to the smaller text, which is really nice. And say if we want to make the text larger, you'll notice that the shape corresponds and changes with it. So no matter what we change the text to, it will always change the rectangle or the shape to be the same size as the text, which is really nice. And like a lot of other templates, you can change the colors. So the white and the blue of the colors you can change. A few other options that you can adjust is the roundness and the skew. So for example, it has a skew by default, but let's say if you wanted it to go the other way, you can just click and drag the slider and make a skew. If you didn't want a skew, you can just make the value 0. And let's say you didn't want a rectangle, you want like a rounded rectangle instead with rounded corners, you can change the roundness up. So if we change the roundness up, you can see that we're adding some rounding to the rectangle shape here. Now, another option you have is to expand the path. So this basically adds padding around the name. You can see once we added some roundness, we're getting pretty close to the name. So if you want to extend that, you can change this value here. And that just adds some padding around the text. And you'll notice that we're cutting into the title option here. And if you want to rearrange just the name, you can do so by using the position slider. So for example, the Y position will just make this go up a little higher. You can see we've rearranged it based on how large it is. One other note too down here is that you can change the opacity of the bar. So say if you didn't want a bar and you just want text only, you can just change this value to 0 and you just have the text. So those are the basic options. You have identical options for the title bar as well. So, you know, you can change out the title. And also just one other note I wanted to mention about this. Say if you didn't want a title and you just want the name, all you really have to do is just delete the text. So just put nothing here and then just change the title bar opacity to 0. And you essentially just have the name. So like I said, this is very highly interactive. You can make this however you want. It's very customizable. So that's the benefit of using this template here. Now, one other thing I wanted to note is that you can make it as long or as short as you want. So say if you want the lower third just up there for a few seconds, like right here, you can just simply click and drag the edge to trim it and it will automatically animate off quicker. So, you know, you can see it kind of comes in, comes out, and it's very quick. And likewise, if you wanted this a very long lower third, say, you know, you want it to be up there for 2 minutes or so, you can easily just click and drag the edge and the same animation applies at the end of the 2 minute lower third, it will animate off. So this is very highly customizable, easy to use. So feel free to go grab it and use it in your own video editing projects here. Like I said, thank you again for supporting the channel. It really means a lot. And I look forward to bringing you several more videos to come. All right, that does it for this video. I'll see you guys in the next one. Take care.